and everything.
Mm-hmm.
Morning.
Okay, sure, we'll get a shirt on the way up.
Oh,
very
good.
It's really pretty. Let's go down this one. We'll get it on the way up. We'll get it on the way with the shirt and stuff. Thank you.
We got a map, Mom. I didn't get a map.
I think we used one.
We can share it. We can all share one.
But you know what the map is for, Caitlin? Did you read it? Give it to your sissy. Let her read it really quick.
It is. Oh, yeah. Learn more about him.
Caitlin, save your chat.
There you go.
What do you use this for?
Awesome. So this is our really cool kind of pamphlet. You can go onto the beach and you can look for the colored umbrellas, and there'll be cast members there where you actually do different activities to learn about sea turtles and how to protect them. So once you go over to those little umbrellas, you'll do the activities and you'll get stamps and try to collect all of them.
That's cool, isn't it?
Yeah.
But we do help.
I see a lot of colors.
Are you guys excited?
Yeah! We have to try to find the color umbrellas, and then
everything in their shoes.
And then on.
What happens when you go to the beach? No, I'm gonna leave mine on. They have nice sandals on. Well, if they get uncomfortable, you can take them off, and we'll carry them. We'll put them in Mommy's purse. Just go. Well, we'll figure it out. Let's go over there. No, just walk normal. It's fine. Look at these Florida girls walking like they've never been on sand before.
Not with sandals. That's for
Wait. Be careful. Hold on.
Let's
see the turtles first, because the turtle is first, and then, yeah. I'm going to figure it out.
You see
Cruz?
It starts August 1st.
Does everybody know what we're here for today?
So you're voting for
Sally or
Cruz? Your favorite turtle?
It's
not Sally's.
Colonials or turtles?
What?
So
this one's Cruz. And this one over here is Sally. Yes. Yeah. Oh, it doesn't matter, Sally or Cruz, because it's different turtles around the world that they release.
Oh,
yes. August 1st it starts. The website's on the bottom.
Okay.
And you can start tracking them. Yeah.
Awesome.
Yeah. Thank
Sally
and Cruz are turtles this year.
Very cool.
Yes.
Like Cars 3.
Yes, exactly.
I can choose.
Yeah. So,
I
like
we can track them. We can go online and we can track them.
You can go that way.
I know which one I like the best.
Pretty cool, right?
So like there's Sally.
Sally's ready to go.
Yeah. They're both on.
Yeah, well, mini massage this morning. You're getting a transmitter put on in any minute.
Yeah, see, look.
Do you know how old these are?
Exactly how old now. Yeah. We know they're sexually mature, so that means they're at least 30. It takes that long to become sexually mature.
Right.
Who says? Like they're gonna put a transmitter on her so they can follow her and make sure she knows.
You can go to tortatortles.org and follow these two turtles online.
That's awesome.
You can learn about where they go, what they're doing.
They are sponsored. So we have our first turtle named Sally, Sally Carrera, and she is sponsored by Disney's Animal Science and Environment and the Disney's Vero Beach Resort. And we are members of the Disney's Animal Science and Environment, and our job is to come out and do important conservation work and protect animals all throughout the world. That's a pretty cool thing to be sponsored by.
That's pretty awesome. And
you guys like sea turtles?
Yeah.
By the you know, they make a great subject for a school report. So if you have to do a report this year in school, look up sea turtles. It makes a great subject. Pretty cool.
Great. And so has anybody familiar with the tour
de France? Yes, thank you.
This is the same concept, just a little bit slower. So everybody has to be patient for our turtles here.
Yeah, so so we got sponsors, we got Jelonians, they're racing, and like, what are they racing for?
Funny you should ask. So what are they racing for? So sea turtles are threatened by a myriad of threats out there, big old blue, and also here on the nesting beach. So we're racing to bring awareness to the threat. So Sally here is going to race to bring awareness to light pollution. So what that means is sea turtles coming up and nesting on our beaches at night, and little hatchlings that hatch out of our beaches and head all the way back towards the ocean need to be able to find the ocean. And they do that via natural starlight and moonlight reflecting off of the water. If there's artificial lighting coming from condos or houses from the other direction, the turtles can become really disoriented. And this is one of the major threats that sea turtles face, and Sally is racing to raise awareness about that threat.
That's awesome. So they're kind of like
stirring
on the like, that's awesome.
Just like that, they're racing into Tour de Turtles history here on the 10th annual tour.
Awesome. Okay, that's awareness. Every single one of these sea turtles is a winner, and so are all of you for helping raise awareness and participating with this. So you guys are great. Thank you so much for being out here. So we have some awesome activities today where we can learn even more about how to help these sea turtles out. So we're going to be highlighting some of them, but also you can see all these umbrellas over here. Walk around, participate with people, see what's going on. We have this awesome stamp adventure guide. If you've seen this. This is super cool. So if you open this up, you'll see a bunch of different activities there where you can participate in the activities, learn about sea turtles and other sorts of things, and get stamps as you go along the beach. So make sure you pick one of these up if you don't have it. Kids participate. It's super, super cool.
I actually found running along a highway, and she had a really hard time being adopted because of all this energy she has. But when Pepe found her in the shelter, he knew he'd be able to utilize that energy for the perfect working dog. So she spent months training with him. And now she loves it out here on the beach, and she loves her job.
Dude, that's so awesome. What an amazing journey, huh? She went from the interstate to the intertidal zone. That just blows my mind. I absolutely love it. So why do you actually need to find these eggs? Like, why do you do all this?
Well, it's really important for our conservation team to be able to find the eggs. That way we can mark the nest. So we mark it with stakes and flagging tape like you guys will see out here on the beach. And that's really important not only to protect the nest, but it's also really important for us to be able to count the eggshells that are left over when the hatchlings leave and go to the ocean. That way we can get the success of the nest.
Awesome, man. That is such talent and dedication. I absolutely love what you guys do.
Well, Dory Snows does the hard part, but I have a lot of beach to cover this morning, guys, and Dory's ready to get back to work, so I gotta get out of here.
All right. Let's hear it for Dory and Captain Ron. You guys are amazing. All right. Loading it. Can you believe this dog? This dog, it like rides in like more style than I do.
It's smiling, but it's not.
Thank you, guys.
No. Okay, does this happen to sea turtles sometimes?
Yeah. It awesome.
Does. So, they need
our help. Thank you, Rebecca. Thank you, Peppy.
So,
thank you, Dory.
Luckily
thank
for
you,
us, we have things on our body to help us
so
out,
so let's
right?
give it up to our furry and not so furry conservation friends with a big old round of applause. They deserve it.
We need to help them out and ruin this. But to make it a little bit more challenging, we always make
the all right, we're going to take a short break. We'll be back with more trivia and interviews and all sorts of rad stuff coming up.
So, if you guys would like, you can try to remove that with one of the
and if you
want
to meet Captain Ron himself, he's got a kiss
fine too. But can you help us remove some of that from our sea turtles? Make them help.
Get on over there. It's super, super cool. We'll check back in later.
Yeah, you guys can put your booklets down.
I'm putting that here.
Who's up for the challenge? Nobody?
Go ahead. Here, jump in. Try to remove that from the turret.
Beach, you put it in the recycling bin. And it's important to put it in the recycling bin even at home because there's a good chance that if it's on the ground at home, it could end up in a drain and then all the drain leads to the ocean, right? So. Really, really important that all the bottles go in the right place the first time. If you see them on the beach, you can see them.
in the process of great job. How about anything else in the ocean that doesn't belong there?
I think that's fantastic. That's very, very cool.
Yeah, great job. And so we see the trash bag and we see the jellyfish.
Exciting. It's about to happen. Looks so I'm going to put your attention over here to my right. We have a nest.
Very good. But it's just a curl. Both of these kind of hold it now.
We also had a special little surprise yesterday. On your way back over there, the next little marked nest that's just right over there, it has a nice little divot in it. And right after the thunderstorm, the sand cooled off and all the hatchlings came out of there. And so several guests got to see that, which is pretty rare. Usually it happens at night and you don't get the opportunity to see that. So when you go back over, you can take a look at that little divot there, and that's where the when all of the eggs started to hatch, and when all the eggs started to hatch and they started to thrash around, there's some spaces in the eggshells, then all of that, the sand, everything, as they're trying to swim their way up through the sand, and then they're starting to work
out from that side of there. When the black
hole
I don't feel as I woke up at 1:30 this morning.
Yeah.
Good job.
Awesome. Good job, yeah.
Okay, then take the turtle.
Conservation hero. Tyler, were you up at 1:30?
Here you go, little turtle.
Little turtle, yeah.
Yay, escape, little turtle, escape.
Do y'all know what this device is? Wow.
Yay, good job, little turtle.
And we know we already got school. Hi, you want to see the sea turtle nest? So this is just a model. This is what a green sea turtle nest looks like. So here are the babies, and they're all the way down to the bottom, too. So when they hatch, they all have to make their way up to the top, and then where do they go? To the ocean, exactly. So do you guys know how we can help them get to the ocean? How can we help a sea turtle? So if the ocean has trash in it and they eat that trash, do you think that's good? No, so we want to make sure our ocean's clean, right? But do you guys ever go to the beach and build a sandcastle? Yeah, me too. I like digging holes and building sandcastles. These guys, they don't like it though. If they hit a sandcastle, they think they're going the wrong way, and then they turn around and go away from the ocean. And we don't want that to happen. So when you leave the beach, kick those sandcastles down and fill the holes back up, and that'll make sure that these guys get out there a lot faster. Good idea? You always do that high five. Good job. You guys have any questions about sea turtles? Did you get to see ours yet that we're going to release? Yeah, so those are two moms that already laid eggs here on this beach last night. And then we're putting a tracker on them now, and then we're going to send them out to the ocean and see where they go. That's a good question. So we're still studying, but right now about 70 years is the average that we're saying. But there are some moms out there that are in their 90s that are still laying eggs. Pretty cool, right? Yeah. Good question as well. So, depends on which type of nest it is. So, this is a green sea turtle like Crush. They can have upwards of 200. Some of the other species, only 80. So, anywhere between 80 and 200. But the cool thing is, a lot of the moms come up on the beach more than once during the season. So, the ones that you saw over there, they'll actually come up on the beach 4 or 5 times and lay 120 eggs each time. Yeah. So they're trying to make sure that all of your babies can make it out to the ocean and survive. Because they've got a hard life even in the ocean. They have to find food. When they're this big, the water kind of pushes them around. So they have to swim really hard to get everywhere. So only 1 in 1,000 make it to be grown-ups. Yes, that's your question. We do not. We know the girls now because they came to lay eggs now. But we won't know until they're 30. Once they're 30, they're full grown. So they'll be the size of this guy over here, or this girl. So when you look, let's go look at him.
All right, so look at her tail.
They tag her little flipper tags.
Is your tail, is it longer than her flippers or short?
shorter. So that means she's a girl. If it's longer when they're adults, they're boys.
They never come back. They never see their children. It's very, very hands-off parenting.
Very cool.
Isn't that a neat fact?
Yeah. She'll lay, they nest.
Yeah,
we'll get you guys to see. They'll nest about every other year. And they might nest like 5-6 times.
Ooh, you guys are doing good.
So like a loggerhead would lay like 60 to 100, maybe a little bit more, yeah.
Good job, girls.
Keep protecting those sea turtles, okay? And you guys can grab their
little softer ones, but they look just like this. They she covers them.
Way to go, guys! Sally is up first. Ready?
All right, ready, folks. Is Sally ready? Time for the countdown. Here we go. Ready for the countdown? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5,
louder.
6, 7, 8, 9, 10, ka-chow!
Here comes Sally!
Here she comes! Oh, dude! She's out! She's out of the gates! Cruising,
one might say.
not to jump to conclusions, but based on the results so far, I feel like Cruz is ahead. Pick it up, dear. No fair, Sally broke trail. Next year. Have a great day. This has been Zach and Rachel.